Welcome, everyone, to Cell Phones in the Classroom, Instructional Friend or Foe. Today, I'm going to be talking about, in our fifth webcast here, about QR codes. All right, now, I know all of you have seen these codes. You might not know what the name is, but I think if I show you here the next slide, yes, there it is, the infamous QR code. They're everywhere around us. They're in our stores. They're in our malls. They're on advertisements now. What are these things, and what are they used for, and how in the world can they possibly be used for education with cell phones? QR code, the Q and the R, stands for quick response. This is just really a fancy barcode. We're used to barcodes in all of our products, but a barcode, right, has those vertical lines that can only be read across. A QR code is very versatile. It can be read across the image, up and down, sideways, whatever direction you want to, and it actually allows you to store much more data on that particular code than your standard barcode, which is really kind of neat. And what's really, I think, exciting about these QR codes is that anyone can generate one for free in most cases, and that code will be yours. It won't change. It will be yours forever. So as teachers, educators, we can certainly link these codes to various parts of our classroom instruction. And now students can use their cell phones. Every cell phone, a smartphone, has an app for scanning QR codes. And now we could bring that phone into another dimension of our classroom instruction. All right, so that's what we're going to talk about today. Now, oh, there it goes. It's very excited to be here. Now, the first thing you need in order to create your own QR code is a QR code generator. Now, there are a lot of these on the market. If you Google QR code generator, you'll get a bazillion. So they're all pretty good. The one that I use is actually a website called QRStuff.com. Okay, now I'm gonna go to the website here. If I can kind of bring that up quickly, and there it is. QRStuff.com, QRStuff.com. This is a great one. Most of the QR code generators are free. Now, they do have some paid functions, which basically allows you to keep statistics and track how many times your code has been scanned, and I don't really know who's scanning it and that sort of thing. I've never thought that would be useful for what I want to do with these. So I've never paid for any of this. So this is all pretty free. Now this is actually a really, really, really cool site. I think the first place I would suggest you guys go to would be QR codes. And they kind of give you a great example of what a QR code is and how it works and how they're created. And there's a lot of like YouTube videos here that you could watch about QR codes. They're fine. But real quickly, let me talk to you about how this site works and what you can actually do with it. All right. Now, you can see here on the left-hand side, one, you have to decide what sort of data type do you want to link your QR code to. It could be a website, a URL address. I use that a lot, and I'll show you some examples in a moment. A YouTube video. Maybe there's a really great YouTube video that you show in class or something, a clip of some sort. You can now link that YouTube link to a QR code. A student can scan that QR code off a worksheet, and now they could watch that video. Now you bring in video, or you bring in other documents into a static piece of paper, which I think is really cool. Google Maps, Twitter, Facebook, you could do plain text, a telephone number, an email message, really kind of neat stuff here. So you can kind of go down the line. And then once you select it, and I'll go through this, it generates a QR code for you, and you download the code, and it's yours. Now, there's really some neat stuff here. You could put QR codes on hats, on shirts. I'm a moderator of a club at my school called the History Society, and we're making a t-shirt. And on that t-shirt, we put a QR code, which opens up a YouTube video. Really, really neat stuff. Students really think it's kind of fun. So you'd be walking down the hall, and a student can scan a person's shirt. Really, really some exciting things here. So that's the site that we're going to be using today. And I want to kind of now talk about how the way I use QR codes in my classroom and what I do with my teaching. So I want to give you some real examples here so you have a better sense of what I'm talking about. All right. Now, let me kind of go into my website that I use, and let me stress something really important here. With all of the cell phone technology, again, we can't assume that every single student has a smartphone that can scan QR codes. With that said and done, everything I create for QR codes, I make sure it's available on my website. So a student can use a computer at school, a student can use a computer at home to access this material. And I think that goes across the board for all of our cell phone techniques that we've been talking about here. Always make sure it's available in other formats so students who do not have cell phones can definitely access that material or that activity. Here are my study guides that I use for AP US History, and I really tried to put QR codes in those study guides to link that piece of paper that students print out to this digital world, to cell phones in the classroom. So here would be a study guide, chapter 6, it's about the revolution and so forth. And you can see here I put some extra credit videos right on the study guide where students now can scan that QR code and a YouTube video pops up that's about, you know, some of this material. The way I've used that is extra credit, that I've now maybe put some bonus questions on a test that students who have watched the video now can get some extra points, a way to sort of reinforce the material. As I move down through my study guide here, one thing, here's my Quizlet vocabulary that we've all been talking about before, and there's my Quizlet link. I'm going to now add, I think, a QR code right here that now I can now stake students can scan that QR code and go right to that Quizlet material, which is another way to bring Quizlet and cell phones into your classroom. Moving on down the study guide, traditional notes and so forth that I put on my study guides. Here's some graphic organizers. But now I always have my students read primary sources. Okay, so here is Patrick Henry's very famous speech, "Give me liberty or give me death," that I'm sure everybody's familiar with. Now a student can now, for this assignment, they have to sort of summarize the document here and actually write it on this piece of paper, and we discuss it in class, and here's one for the Stamp Act Congress, right? Now a student can actually scan that code in the hall with their smartphone, read that primary source on their phone, and answer the questions right here in the study guide. Really neat, very, very easy. Students thought this was really cool and they really, really, really liked it. So again, you could put these anywhere on your study guide. You could put them in your classroom, things of that nature. So that's what I really wanted to kind of show you. All right, now, kind of moving on here. Creating a QR code. This is very, very easy. All right, so I'm gonna go step by step through the website, show you how I actually do this, and you'll see that you can do this in a matter of minutes. Okay, now let's go to qrstuff.com, and let me kind of go flip back and forth here. Say this is a study guide that I'm working on, and I want my students to read a sermon by a minister in the 18th century, Jonathan Edwards, and the sermon is called Sinners in the Hands of an Angry God. All right, now, so what I want to do is first, I kind of set this up. I found the easiest way is to actually insert a little text box first, draw a text box. Oh, I know I made a mistake. I had that highlighted. Insert a text box. Draw the text box right there. Okay, now let's generate the QR code first. I probably should have done that first. Let's go into here, into the QRstuff.com. I'm going to use the website URL. Now what I need to do is I need to go back to my website. Here's really important. Anything that you're going to use for website URL, you need your own classroom webpage to make sure these files are available so you can have a link. It needs a link. You need the link to sort of create that QR code. So let me go back to my primary sources. There they all are. These are all the primary sources I use in class. And I know Edwards is down here. Here it is, Edwards, Sinners in the Hands of an Angry God. I click that. It opens over here. There's the online document. So a student can read this at home, certainly. But I want to make a QR code. There's the link. I copy the link. Okay. I go into QRstuff.com. And now I paste the link there. All right. And boom, there's your code. All right. I want to download the code. Okay, I'm going to save it as. Now I already have this saved, but we'll just sort of play around here a little bit. Let me go to my class. This is AP US History. I know this is from my textbook, and I know this is in here somewhere. All the things that I've done. All right, there are all my QR codes, and there it is. I'm just going to override it. Okay, I'm going to replace it. Now it's saved. Okay, that's it. You saved it. Now you can play with the colors, and you can give it different colors and that sort of thing if you really want to. Now I go back to my study guide, okay, and I go insert picture. I gotta remember where I saved that particular picture. Okay, I know I saved it in my APUS history folder. Okay. And there are all the QR codes. I just make sure I saved it. I give it a real name so you know where to find it. It's going to have a bunch of numbers. So there it is. There's the hands of an angry god. I insert it. There's the QR code. And if you want to, you could erase this text box. Just go to format the text box. It's always a hard time getting that to come up. Format the text box. And the line, I just, you know, get rid of the color of the line. And there it is. Okay, so now students can actually scan that QR code, and that sermon will actually come up on their device, which is, I think, is really kind of neat. Okay, now I want to kind of go back to the PowerPoint here. So, what do students need? All you need is your computer to create these, and you can find a website like QRStuff.com to generate the QR codes. Students need to download apps on their phone, whether an iPhone or a Droid, so they can actually scan these. There are numerous apps. They're all over the place. Most of them are all free. And some of the basic ones for iPhone are Shop Savvy is really good, Red Laser, QuickScan Pro, Neo Reader. These are all free or 99 cents, very inexpensive. For Android devices, many, QR Droid, QR Barcode Scanner, Red Laser, Barcode Scanner. I use Barcode Scanner. It's very easy. Image pops right up, all right, after you scan it, or a website, or a YouTube video. Really, 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 really neat stuff. Now, other uses, you can really get creative here and go beyond just putting QR codes on a study guide. There are a lot of things you can do. You can create interactive worksheets. That's basically what I showed you, where now your worksheets are maybe linked to a music. You want to put music in your worksheet. You want to put a podcast, which we're going to get to in a little bit, on your worksheets, things of that nature. You can create your own Choose Your Own Adventure. All of us read those Choose Your Own Adventure books, where now students can scan a code, and that will take them to a different direction in a story. Kind of really neat. Students can create their own, right? And this could be a student project. It doesn't have to be your material that you're creating. Make this a student-created project. Really neat things that are available here for you. Certainly interactive math worksheets. Why not create a math worksheet, and then now the QR code maybe pops up a YouTube video where it shows a student how to complete that problem. Really, really, really neat stuff there. All right. Virtual museum displays. You know, create a museum in your classroom, and maybe there's photographs, and you scan the QR code, and an explanation comes up. Or you can also do those sorts of things. Or maybe if you scan the QR code, the right answers appear on a worksheet. There's a lot of possibilities here. Link to music, as I said, or a podcast. One really last thing I'm going to show you just really, 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 really quickly is a site called QRvoice.net. Okay, let me kind of show you that. And that's kind of neat that now you can type something in here up to 100 characters. It will generate the QR code. And then when the students scan that QR code, a computer voice, you know, will actually read that message to the students. Up to 100 characters. So that's kind of neat. You can really do a lot of really cool things with that. That's QRvoice.net. Okay, so again, like all of these sort of new techniques, experiment, try just one, fool around with it. I think you're going to notice the students are really going to like the QR codes. I think they're really, 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 really fun. So as always, if you have any questions about this and share your ideas about how you might incorporate these into your classroom, that'd be wonderful. So please contact me with any questions. Thank you, and have a great day.